Hey guys, Corey Hutton at Free Play Arcade here, back in the secret lab, testing out a really, really cool Bally Sente SAC1 wood cabinet. Right now we're gonna play some Goalie Ghost.
The story of Goalie Ghost and the SAC1 starts with a familiar name, Nolan Bushnell. Nolan Bushnell has one of the most storied histories in all of electronic gaming history. He founded Atari, Chuck E. Cheese, and has more than 20 venture-funded video game companies to his name. But after selling Atari to Warner in 1978, Bushnell was totally out of the video game creation world and subject to a super strict 5-year non-compete agreement with Warner. 4 years after signing that agreement, however, Bushnell wanted back in. Enter Videa, an upstart video game developer founded by former Atari employees Roger Hechter, Howard Delman, and Ed Rotberg. Using his Chuck E. Cheese Pizza Time entity, Bushnell bought Videa for $2.2 million in 1983, reformed it as Sente Technologies as a division of Pizza Time Pizza.
Have you got a video game in mind, or what is ahead for video games as far as Nolan Bushnell sees it?
Let's just say that we have a division. It's called Sente. Sente turns out to be the one move in the game of Go that beats an Atari.
I don't know why.
Though he believed the structure of the deal wasn't violative of his non-compete with Warner, Atari sued Bushnell. Bushnell settled the lawsuit by giving Atari the exclusive home publishing rights for the new Sente Technology games. Then during 1983, Sente was focused on hardware development of what was to be the revolutionary Sente arcade computer system, which was novel for being one of the first arcade systems to use interchangeable PCBs and quick swap control panels to allow operators to quickly and cheaply convert arcades from one game to another. Sente believed that interchangeable games would address the primary complaint from arcade operators in the early and mid 80s, where they were having to constantly buy $10,000 arcade cabinets, and it was impossible to use, or at least not easy to use, other arcade games in these cabinets. This problem would eventually result in the JAMA standard, and also the rise of cabinet manufacturer Dynamo, but that's a topic for another video. At Sente, though, progress was going well, developing the hardware and simple games to demonstrate the ease of swapping games in the Sente SAC-1. Sente's first game, Snake Pit, was demonstrated in December 1983, and Snake Pit started shipping soon after in a custom SAC-1 cabinet. But the video game crash of 1984 was far-reaching and caused the funding market for any video game-related project, even kids' pizza arcades, to dry up. In late 1983 and early 1984, Pizza Time Pizza filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy and quickly put Sente up for sale. Bally Midway, famed Pac-Man licensee and arcade manufacturer, scooped up Sente about 6 months after it was officially launched for a cool $3.9 million. And even while in limbo, Sente was working hard on their games. While Snake Pit was the only game done when Pizza Time filed for bankruptcy, Chicken Shift, Off the Wall, Trivial Pursuit, Stalker, Snacks and Jackson, Goalie Ghost, and Hattrick were all finished while Sente waited for the deal with Bally to finish. As such, once Sente officially became Bally Sente, it already had 8 games completed and ready to ship for the Bally Sente now SAC-1 system. Bally Sente would release 2 cabinets for the SAC-1, a deluxe cabinet with a shroud, and a standard wood cabinet that lended itself better to 2-player games. The deluxe cabinet, that original Sente cabinet, proved to be extremely expensive to produce and was not exactly well received, as the shroud kind of prevented 2 people from playing at once easily. As such, all production would quickly shift to the standard wood SAC-1 cabinet, which is what Free Play has, with a planned release to Free Play Richardson soon with Goalie Ghost. That said, and regardless of the unique cartridge system, Sente's games were never huge sellers, and releases slowed down considerably as the years passed. After releasing 12 games in 1984, Sente struggled under the watchful eyes of their corporate Bally bosses. Sente would only release 9 more games until folding in 1988 under the weight of poor sales, virtually zero marketing, and a general late 80s arcade conversion glut. Despite having no hit games, the SAC-1 is now remembered fondly for a handful of all-time great and totally underappreciated titles, like Goalie Ghost, Mini Golf, and Hattrick, games that struck a perfect balance of simplicity and addictive, rewarding gameplay. In the Free Play Collection, we currently have Night Stalker, Gully Ghost, Mini Golf, Trivial Pursuit, and Street Football. And we're always looking for more control panels, cartridges, and marquees. So, shortly after production of this video, expect to find in an original wood SAC-1 cabinet, Gully Ghost, at Free Play Richardson.
Can you give us a hint? Are we going to be just playing the games like we do now, or is there going to be an added dimension possibly?
Well, let's just say that the first few ones that we're going to put out, we don't want to electrify the market too much because we want to build up our manufacturing capability. But we have some things in the lab that I think everyone will say, gee, wished I'd thought of that.